سيد اياد من الاستراتيجيك برودكت سيل سبيشالست فروم فاير اي راح يعرض لنا محاضره بعنوان ايقاف مخاطر امن المعلومات يبدا من مصدرها، كيف ندعم امن الاجهزه الطرفيه. تفضل سيد اياد.
السلام عليكم، يعطيكم العافيه. اول شيء انا اسمي عائد القرطه، معلش سامحونا على الخطا بالطباعه. الاسم عائد القرطه، انا كونسلتنج سيستمز انجينير working for FireEye Middle East. I joined FireEye in 2012. So I covered the region from a consulting and pre-sales support for our customers. Just a quick introduction about FireEye. FireEye is a US-based company founded in 2004. It's based in Milpitas, California. FireEye is the leader in detecting and stopping advanced persistent threats and unknown malware attacks. So we have like 10 years experience and leading the market when it comes to detect unknown attacks and threats. I'm very happy to join you today. My presentation will be talking about the cyber threat landscape, the advanced attacks that we observe in the market, how FireEye technology can help customers to detect these type of attacks and prevent them. Now, before talking about technology, I would like to talk about the threat landscape and the attackers from our experience. Now, APT actors or advanced threat attackers, when they want to infiltrate into any network, they need to follow a systematic approach. We call it the cyber kill chain. So the cyber kill chain, it's a term coined by Lockheed Martin, which explains the attack life cycle and how threat actors, they can bypass all your defenses and steal sensitive information or do any damage. It always starts with external recon or external reconnaissance. They need to study your organization. They need to choose their targets, the internal victims, and they rely on the web. So they go to social media like LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, etc. So they will learn about their victims. They will choose the victim inside the organization, and they will try to track this user by sending him some suspicious emails with social engineering techniques in order to ask this user to open some fake documents or attachments. So I can send any email to any person today, and I can change the source to look like someone who I trust. So it can come from Minister of Interior, it can come from a bank, it can come from a trusted person. And the email body, it can contain any material. They can go to your website, to today we have this conference. After you go back to work, I can send you an email as a follow-up to attending this conference, and please check the attached presentation. The file can contain weaponized content. It can contain Trojan horse or information stealer tools. So once they study the environment and choose their targets, they will start to go to the next stage, which is the initial compromise. They will send you the fake email or the spear phishing, or send you an email with an embedded URL to take you to a weaponized or malicious website. Once they compromise the system by downloading the threat into your machine, they will establish a foothold. They will have a connection into your network in order to move laterally and to access more classified or sensitive information. So I can send the email to your system admin, and once I infect the system, I can move from this workstation to other server VLANs or data centers in order to steal whatever I'm looking for. And this is the way how all the APT operations or incidents that we hear about it today, it follows the same sequence. They have to send you a spear phishing email or to access a malicious website, then they will infect your system. Once they infect the system, they have a full control. They can access it wherever they are. They can access the system from the internet, and they need to maintain a presence. They need to laterally spread inside your organization. So as a threat actor, I don't want to infect your system only for hours. I want to stay inside your environment for days and months. So FireEye, we release quarterly and yearly reports, and we share some real statistics. One of the statistics is that it takes customers around 205 days to discover that they are being breached, that there is a threat actor inside the environment. So imagine that there is a hacker or a hacker group, they are accessing your network on a daily basis for 4 months, and nobody knows about them. Why? Because they are using very advanced evasion techniques. They can avoid your detection mechanisms in order to steal information and exfiltrate banking information, oil and gas information, government-related information, etc. In this region, the Middle East, it's highly targeted by so many threat actors, whether they are state-sponsored actors, sponsored by their countries, or they are looking for some espionage activities to steal your information that are related to some sensitive projects or sensitive energy or oil and gas business or government classified information which can help some third parties. Now, once they finish their mission, they will exfiltrate the data outside, from outside the network, and that's it. So this is the life cycle of attacks that we see today. So when we identify the attack life cycle and the attack stages, we will be able to tune our defenses and to make sure you have to stop or delay the attacker as early as possible. You don't want to leave the attacker to reach to the last stage and try to engage with him, because it will be very difficult. Once they are inside the network, they are one of your team. They will steal sensitive credentials related to the domain admin, and they will start accessing servers and networks as a normal system admin. That's why they maintain very long presence inside the network. So the idea here is we don't want the attacker to reach to the final stage. We want to stop him as early as possible. And that's where FireEye can help customers to stop the attack from the initial stages. So let's talk about the adversaries, the attackers. Today, the problem is not about malwares. Our problem is not against a malware. It's against the human being who programmed these malwares and who is controlling these threats to access our organizations. Now, all the incidents that we hear about today in the news, it's not only a malware piece. We are talking about a human being who programmed this threat to access your network, and from there he will start to move laterally inside the environment. So the problem, it's against the humans. Why? Because they are very smart. So it's not the what, it's the who. Who is targeting you? Who is trying to steal your information? Who is trying to exfiltrate sensitive information from the network? So once we identify that the problem, it's a who, it's a person, we have to identify who are these threat actors, who are these groups, what are their TTPs, the tactics, techniques, and procedures. So each threat group around the world, they have their own profile. So there are groups specialized in targeting financial organizations. There are groups specialized in targeting oil and gas, or government, or defense. And in FireEye, we track more than 300 global groups around the world who are specialized in targeting organizations, and we keep catching them every time we investigate an incident. So if you heard about the Sony breach, it was FireEye who investigated this breach. Why? Because it's the go-to company now to investigate high-profile breaches. So these threat actors, they are highly skilled, they are sophisticated, they are sponsored by their nations, and they have goal to finish and execute, which is to get into your network, to bypass your defenses, and exfiltrate sensitive information. And they are very persistent. If you kick them out once, they will come back again using more tricks and more tools to bypass your defenses. So if someone managed to get into your network and somehow you catch them and you block the malware or you formatted the system, they will come again using a different way, and that's why they are persistent. This is the B in the APT, Advanced Persistent Threat. They keep coming again and again. So talking about the traditional model now, we used to rely on traditional products like the antivirus, firewalls, web gateways, etc., to protect ourselves. This was used to be very good in the past, but now cyber attackers, they can bypass its defenses, and signature-based tools are not effective anymore. And the reason why we came to this conclusion is that when we investigate, when we go to customers who are already breached and do the investigation and forensics, we discovered that it's not a recent infection. It took like around 1 or 2 or 3 months for this customer to discover that they are being breached. So 3 months to this, being undetected, and it takes around a month to remediate. So this is a shocking fact. So 205 days for customers to know that they are breached. 69% of these customers, they knew about this breach from outside entities, like CERT or like the FBI or any equivalent organization, security companies. They will call these customers and will tell them, Mr. Customer, your network is breached and we are seeing sensitive data leaving your network. So they don't have internal capability to detect the breach or to discover the threat actors. Now, another shocking factor is that 100%, all of these customers, they had up-to-date antivirus. So all of these customers that we investigated, they had up-to-date antivirus, and yet they were breached. So the antivirus failed to protect these customers, and any similar signature-based defenses will never stop these attackers because they know how to avoid these products. They know the weaknesses in these products. So with FireEye, we are distributed globally. So we monitor all the threats around the world. Even we have a FireEye cyber threat map available on our website. You can access the website and see the map. We have customers who requested us to create a customized map for them, which is relevant to their environment only. So they can see incoming attacks targeting their environment and outbound callbacks from infected systems. So a system, when it's infected, it has to call back to a remote server where it can report and upload data or receive commands or receive more information. So you will see inbound attacks and outbound connections leaving from your network and trying to reach to remote command control and servers. So with FireEye, as a leader in the market, we have a complete framework. We have a complete adaptive defense concept which relies on 3 main pillars. Technology, expertise, and intelligence. So technology alone is not enough. You have to get the right threat intelligence which is actionable and relevant to your environment. So since we detect these threat actors on a daily basis and analyze millions of malwares, we generate actionable intelligence to help our customers understand these type of threats, to understand the nature of these attacks and the TTPs, tactics, techniques, and procedures. So when I tell you, Mr. Customer, we know about a threat group which is specialized in targeting government customers in the Middle East. So you will ask me, okay, give me more information. Give me more context. Tell me how do they operate? What are their tools? How they bypass my defenses? How can I tune my defenses and my SOC monitoring tools to catch these attackers as soon as they try to infiltrate into my network? And this is the type of actionable intelligence which you can help your technical team to tune their defenses and the strategic team, the C-level employees, users. So the board and C-level, like CEO, CIO, they can take informed decisions by learning about the latest trending attacks in the region. So we can provide you intelligence related to the Middle East and related to certain vertical like government or oil and gas or financial, etc. So this will be very relevant and focused on your line of business. And the third part is the expertise. Because we are the go-to company now, we are very well known on the internet. If you Google for FireEye or Mandiant, so Mandiant is a company that we acquired in 2014, which is the number one company in the US and worldwide for incident response and investigations. So high profile breaches like Sony, JP Morgan Chase, Target, and other breaches, they always call us to investigate the breach. Why? Because they know about our expertise. We can solve the problem. We can discover what happened and provide this information to the customer. So from a technology perspective, we have a patent technology called MVX, Multi-Vector Execution Engine. So when the company was founded in 2004, the main focus was on discovering advanced threats, discovering unknown malwares and vulnerabilities and exploits without relying on signatures. So the MVX engine is our purpose-built security hypervisor, which is used to discover unknown attacks. And all of our products are powered by this MVX engine. First, it's a signature-less detection. We don't rely on signatures at all, because we know the signature-based products are not effective anymore. It's a purpose-built, so we are not using third-party virtualization hypervisors like VMware or Hyper-V or VirtualBox, which can easily detect it by malwares and threat actors. So if you want to detect advanced threat actors and advanced malwares, you have to develop a very advanced technology to accommodate this level of sophistication. I can't go to a war or to a gunfight with a knife. Okay, so we use this analogy. If you are going to a gunfight, you didn't go with a knife. You should go with the same level of weapon. And again, it's a patent technology registered in the US. So FireEye was one of the first companies in the market to introduce the concept of advanced sandboxing technology. So we have around 10 years of R&D and experience, and that's what put us in the front line and on the headlines wherever there is any advanced threats and targeted attacks. So one more thing about the intelligence. Because we have this advanced sandboxing products, we discovered around 20 zero-days vulnerabilities since 2013 till today. And it's more than all of our competitors combined. Why? Because we are specialized in this target. So let's talk about the technology. This is the MVX. This is the main component of our platform. So the MVX, it's a multi-vector, multi-execution engine. Multi-vector, multi-flow execution engine. So when we talk about multi-vector, it means we cover different attack vectors. So threats can come from the web, email, file, endpoint, and mobile. So five sources, five attack vectors. Anyone can target you using one of these vectors. So if you want to protect yourself from these threats or these vectors, you have to rely on a technology which can understand and cover these and these vectors. So the network, which is the internet, the technology can analyze up to 2 million objects per hour. The only technology in the market that can go to this level of analysis. Why? Because we understand how these threats work. It's a very complex problem. Attackers, they can deliver the threats in large number of objects in different sessions. So imagine when you have 500 or 1,000, 2,000, 4,000 desktops in the network and they are browsing the internet. So they will generate hundreds of thousands of internet requests per day. And in order to detect complex attacks, you have to analyze all of these requests, every single object, every single web page. So we don't analyze objects alone. We analyze web pages, we analyze the scripts, we analyze flash files, Java files, flash files, PDFs, etc. So all type of files that can be weaponized. So threat actors today, they can infect your systems using executables, they can infect the systems using documents, using JavaScript, using flash files, using PowerShell, using VB scripting. So the list goes on and on. So if I want to protect myself against all these type of attacks, my technology needs to understand all these type of files and the complexities and permutations of these files. So our environments are very complex. Every system runs different configuration, different number of applications, different versions of applications. So two PCs can be running two different Adobe Reader versions. So if I'm handling this problem, I have to understand that the defense must accommodate the level of sophistication. So we covered the network, email, mobile, and files. So inside the MVX engine, we detonate the suspicious files. Detonate means we execute. We replay it inside the virtual machine. So we have actual Microsoft virtual machines. So we are not emulating. We are not simulating code. We are not sending data to the cloud. Everything is executed on premises. Why? Because we have to maintain the data privacy. We have to make sure we see the full session. We have to see all the flows. So if I only pick simple files for analysis, definitely the technology will miss advanced or complex attacks, which is separated in different flows. So if I'm sending you a single file, it's a very easy threat. But if it's a very complex threat that can bypass defenses, you have to simulate all the flows inside the virtual machine. So when we detonate, we can discover the attack lifecycle. So we can discover exploitation attempt, any attempt to attack a security bug in your software. Second, we can detect any attempt to download malware into the system. If the malware is trying to call back to remote command control server, if the malware is trying to move laterally from one system to another, and if there is any attempt to exfiltrate sensitive data like passwords, user accounts, emails, files in the system. Everything will be discovered when we detonate or we analyze these files inside the virtual machine, and we will generate full forensics report which can help you to understand the intention of this attack. And inside these virtual machines, we do correlation. So if we detect one threat related to another, we can provide you with more contextual information to help you understand these type of advanced attacks. Now, talking about intelligence, it's very interesting to know that intelligence is a very crucial part when it comes to information security. Because when we monitor all the customers around the world, we can discover attacks that have never been seen before. So let's assume customer A was targeted with a zero-day malware, a zero-day fresh. So a zero-day means it's never seen before. There is no signature to block it. There is no patch to protect from. And there is no IPS. There is no web filtering rule. There is nothing at all to detect it. So it's completely fresh. This is what we call 0 days. And 0 days are the type of attacks that can bypass all type of signature-based defenses and reach the end users because there is no previous knowledge about it. So when we protect our customers, we make sure that if we see the attack in one customer, the rest of the customer base will be protected. And we have a large number of deployments in around the world and even in the region and even in Kuwait. So since we are doing business in Kuwait since 2011, we have large number of references and customers who are already using our technology to protect their environments, and they are seeing the value. So with the intelligence as a concept, we have to just to give it some time. There's a big difference between raw intelligence, which is feeds coming from the cloud, which contains blacklisted IP addresses or blacklisted domains or MD5s. This is not actionable intelligence. This is raw data, raw information, which we as humans, we can't do anything with this information. It will be used by the products. But in order to understand the threat actors and the way how they act, we have to use what we call actionable intelligence, which was analyzed and confirmed by human analysts. So we have a team of security analysts who are sitting in our office analyzing security information and providing actionable intelligence. So you can use this information which could be relevant to your environment. And it can help you to understand the threat actors who might target my organization, who is specialized in targeting banking sector, who is specialized in targeting oil and gas. So when you get access to this information, you will be able to tune your defenses and make more informed decisions. This is how even the financial market works. So you can see banks, they release quarterly reports on the current state of the market. So investors and companies and the stock analysts, they can understand what is happening in the market and they can predict. So the prediction part is very important. You can predict the next move of the attacker since you already have access to intelligence information that were collected from previous experience. So I can tell you, Mr. Customer, if this threat actor group, which let's call it APT-28. So APT-28, it's a Russian-based group. We know about it, we track it, and we already published some reports on the internet. So these groups are specialized in targeting, let's say, customers and government entities for political reasons that serve Russia and some government, entities. So when I tell you about this group, you will know that, okay, this group is specialized in targeting a certain type of customers. Okay, this is the first info. The second thing is, these groups, when they try to infiltrate into your network, they always use the, specific tools and specific techniques to bypass your defenses. Okay, great. So since I start to learn more and more about the adversaries, the attackers, I will be able to go back to my security team and tell them, okay, team, no, today we know about this group and we receive some information that they might target us. They might target my organization or my bank. And here's the thing. These groups are specialized in these type of attacks. They target these systems. When they manage to successfully get into the network, the next thing, immediately, they attack my Active Directory. Once they attack the Active Directory and steal user accounts, the third thing, usually, they attack my Exchange server to exfiltrate email inboxes and send it outside. So today, we start to learn about the tactics of these adversaries. I will be able to go and learn from these lessons and enhance my defenses and enhance my monitoring. So the moment your security team start to see the first signs of any attack similar to this techniques, you will be able to understand that, okay, this is a targeted attack. We are dealing with a serious threat. This is not a commodity malware. This is not some banking Trojan malware or some password stealing malware. No, no, we are facing some advanced threat. So with FireEye, we have different threat intelligence offering. It depends on how much you want to learn about the attackers. You want to only learn to use the basic intelligence, which can help you to block non-attacks. You want to learn more about these threat actors and groups and their techniques. We can go with the more advanced subscription. And with FireEye, it's one of the only companies in the market which can provide this level of intelligence subscription. So I will jump to the final slides just to summarize. As I said, we are a market leader. We publish so many reports which are available on our website. You can access the website, download these reports. If you can go to FireEye.com and access our reports, you will see like one of the latest reports is talking about some cyber attacks in Syria and in the region. Also, we publish quarterly and yearly reports talking about threat actors around the world and even in the Middle East, so you can get more information about it. Our employees, they also publish books. They are very well known in the industry. Our FireEye as a brand is very well known in the incident response and APT market. I'm looking for just a slide here and I will summarize that. So with FireEye as a company specialized in stopping advanced threats, and we don't do anything else, by the way. This is our own specialty, and we have been doing that since 2004. So the main framework is based on four main stages. So if we want to protect from advanced attacks and cyber attackers, we have to follow this continuous threat protection process, which is to detect the threats, prevent it, and to analyze and respond. If you rely on detection and prevention alone, this is not effective anymore, because if the attackers manage to bypass your detection or prevention technologies and you are not ready to analyze or respond or understand what happened, then it will be a losing game. So that's why to complete the cycle, we should not only rely on detection and prevention, we have to rely also on response and analysis and forensics. That's where FireEye can come to the picture. We have detection, prevention technologies, we have forensics and analysis, and we have response. So with FireEye response services, we can help customers whenever they are breached or they are facing any targeted attack. They can come to FireEye. We have a full team in Dubai, which is busy 24/7. Actually, we don't ask them what they are doing, because they are doing very sensitive work, responding to attacks in the Middle East. They are always busy. And these type of services are available, and customers, they can talk to us offline. So with that, I would finish here. Thank you very much, and enjoy talking to you. Thank you.
شكرا مهندس اياد.